Floyd Mayweather is a power puncher. He's a guy who can hurt you and knock you out with one punch.
This guy's a star. I'm telling you, sign him up, pay him now, I'll pay for it later.
You haven't kicked the name in 6 months, let me tell you.
Not that anyone would know if it was right or wrong. Just past the midway point of round one.
Mayweather is not using his jab, I don't think, as much as they would like him to. If they were to take a peek at this tape, they would like to see that jab going out there more.
Well, he told us yesterday he did not want to slow. He wanted to box. And whoa, up and down. He was hurt by that exchange.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I believe that punch was very legal, the body shot. Good double left hook by Mayweather.
He doubles up with the left.
Well, we said he had power in his punches, and he showed it there. He could bang. Took a left hook, Rapidaka.
And he hits him with a right. And Rapidaka, it's just a matter of time. Number one.
Mayweather. There goes Rapidaka. Making those numbers probably academic.
And I do not think he's getting up, and he is not. This one has been stopped.
Shake, you know that? So I'm gonna go and let you talk to Victor Ortiz, all right? I'm through. They put somebody else up and give me an interview.
What are you talking about?
You heard him. You never give me a fair shake. HBO needs to fire you. You don't know shit about boxing. You ain't shit. You not shit.
I wish I was 50 years younger and I'd kick your ass.
That tells you a fighter is going to be pretty good when he starts off with a good left jab. That could have been the beginning of a good career.
And Cooper goes down on a jab.
That happens once in a lifetime. When you see a guy jab a fighter, then the problem is always open for you. Just step in with a little power and a guy will do it.
Floyd Mayweather smiling at Jerry Cooper and then popping him at will with the jab. And this is an obvious mismatch unless Cooper gets a lucky shot in somewhere. And Floyd Mayweather may get criticized a little bit for showboating, but his dad probably is going to love it.
I'm sure that Mayweather fought tougher pros, tougher fighters in the amateurs than Cooper is.
And referee Mitch Halperin watching as Floyd gets ready to go over to the neutral corner for the second time.
Hey, you okay?
When they go to 8 Oklahoma, you know they're not looking to bring in a winner.
Jerry Cooper says, what was the right answer? Whatever it wasn't the answer that he gave to Halperin when Halperin said, are you okay?
It takes time and experience.
Louis Leha's cousin, Jesse James Leha, here tonight.
across the top one more time.
There was another good right hand that hurt Mihawk.
And a couple of left, one of them to the body, and a short left hand landed inside. He is doing some damage right now. Louis Leija trying to hold on. And Jerry McKenzie's going to get McKinnock as Mark arrives. If Leija were to go down one more time, the fight would be over. He wasn't able to release any punches. He's totally tentative and back on his heels now. For that reason, there's the third knockdown of the first two rounds. Left hook lands. Leija stunned again. And you can stop it anytime. And Jerry McKenzie's going to stop it right there.
Scanning 10. And another big left hook. Catches him slightly. Right hand is solid. Combinations by Mayweather. Too much speed. Maybe too much power too.
He came to see.
Great right hand by Mayweather to Scatty's head.
That's because he's fast.
At this rate, an easy TKO himself.
Look at the uppercuts by Mayweather, snapping Chavez's head back. Brilliant, clean, hard shot from Pretty Boy Floyd, and Chavez backs out, a sign that Floyd is getting to him.
That can fight better.
What a display of skill by Mayweather! What a display of will by Chavez! Standing ovation round! Everybody up! In the Bill Graham Civic Auditorium in San Francisco, they're on their feet for a brilliant championship fight! He was 30-60 in that round, and he's the winner. As Chavez's corner elects to stop the fight. Ronnie Shields telling his fighter, you're taking too many clean shots.
What can you say, I've got
Floyd is saying to us, I got him to punch himself out.
That was the right hand that was deserved, determined to find out whether Sharmbay could take it. Mitchell took it pretty well, but not those two. Now Sharmbay begins
not
to hold
wild up. Wild punches, so wild looking punches usually are all good.
A tailor to make a car.
Well, the trouble is, if you want to trade with Floyd, you've got to face his hand speed. And Mitchell has gotten hit with another hard right hand here that's setting up more struggle.
To impose himself on a real strong welterweight.
Yes, second good. Knockdown. This time the knockdown is on a body shot. We've seen a lot of knockouts on body shots in recent years. Nichols in no hurry to get up, and that's that.
I think Richard Steele saw the territory in front of us.
You see the confidence of Mayweather being champion of the world. You see the reflexes, the speed, I mean, he's trying to break down the confidence of us round after round after round.
Spinning combination from Floyd Mayweather Jr. Catches Burton again with a left hand and a right hand. Burton now needs to tie up. Mayweather displaying his speed, quickness, and a little bit of power here in the second round.
Floyd Mayweather.
You see the speed of him. He's got so much reflex, so much speed. I mean, look at that fight there.
Triples up on the left hook and comes back with a right cross.
We're talking here a ninth round. That kind of speed. So, this man is very fast.
And trainer Nelson Lopez ends it. Throws in the towel. And 1:06 of the ninth round.
Try to finish here. He does.
certainly make that adjustment.
He did.
Al, you know who he reminds me a little bit of? Oh, look at him. He's blowing kisses. He's not going to endear himself to many fans with that. Now, we saw him hot dog in his first couple of pro bouts. I mean, it is.
Best round of the fight for Arroyo by far, the first one he won.
Mayweather looks to answer as we come to the end of round four, scheduled for 10. Except in the final round.
Wow. Look at the body work by Floyd Mayweather. That's the part that really impresses me, because most youngsters wouldn't be doing it. And he knows the combinations to use. The uppercut started it. And that'll go.
Fred Steinwinder the third says this is over in the fifth. Fans don't like it, but I think it's a good stoppage, because I don't think Arroyo was going to rebound from that.
Here or in putting on some drama and theater for us. You think that hurts him at all, George?
It really doesn't help things. You want to go out there, you say you want a lot of money, you say you deserve it, give us something. Listen, tonight, give us a knockout, a clean knockout, and maybe we'll buy a stock.
Juco.
You know, there's absolutely nothing. Juco is hurt by that right hand.
Just as I said, it might go the distance, of course. Floyd hammers Juco with two right hands. And Mitch Halperin counts.
And Juco doesn't look like he wants to go on.
He doesn't know where he is. It happens like that, Larry.
So once again,
he gave it to
him. Mayweather trumped us, just as we were speculating.
I'm buying that stock.
On whether he could put a dramatic ending to this fight with a flourish.
Good amount of his own offense. Now that Manfredi isn't throwing the jab, and there's a good idea. Mayweather with a right over the top stuns Manfredi. Manfredi in trouble. Mayweather pounds away. And Freddie almost went down. He won't take a knee, but he isn't throwing back. Mayweather pounding, pounding. And this one's going to be stopped, too. Now, this stoppage, I'm not quite as critical.
I'm not either. All the way to fighters like Sugar Ray Robinson.
Super quickness of Floyd Mayweather.
That's the best punch in boxing. Corrales has not used a jab all night.
And the second knockdown of the round for Mayweather. And the accumulated punishment by Corrales.
2 seconds left in the round.
And there's the third knockdown of the round.
5, 6.
And you cannot be saved by the bell. But it looks as though Corrales will have a chance.
Just let the jab just fly. Even if you miss it, just throw it.
Another little left hook. Didn't even seem like that big a punch. Corrales' legs are just shot from the multiple punches he's taken. And Diego pulls himself up by the ropes.
He doesn't look like he has much left, Jeff.
No, he's... If he went down on that punch, I think he has very little left.
Two good shots.
Right hand, another knockdown. Fifth knockdown of the fight. Fifth knockdown of Corrales' career. Another mark of what a performance it's been. Ray Woods is up on the apron. That's going to be the end of the fight. And Corrales goes over and nearly accosts his dad for having stopped the fight.
And what he can do is a puncher, so he can get back in the fight with one punch. That's it.
I don't think Floyd's worried about his punches anymore.
That's it.
Looked like three or four straight right hands.
Mick Durant is going to throw in the towel. Mick Durant is showing Endo the towel. And Endo saying, no, don't throw it in. Endo is shaking his head at Durant saying, no, no, don't throw the towel in. And now the referee does it for him.
Who else, compatriot? Joe Calzaghe, who's 44 and up. He's been squashed his
life.
What a left hook.
A check left hook.
What a left hook.
He never saw it.
What a perfect shot. took by Mayweather. And that tells you everything you know.
And he is on shaky legs.
Yeah,
he's on shaky legs. He's got to buy time here.
Well, he's not the type of fighter that knows how to do it.
Every situation for Hatton.
This fight is over. Floyd Mayweather has a knockout victory over Ricky Hatton.
Motherfuckers know who's the best. If it ain't Fat Joe, then it must be Lord Finesse. Damn, it's the return of the funky man. I'm hip to the game.